Hi there, this is Chris. So today I'm gonna talk about Agentforce. So this is basically a beginner's guide to Agentforce, mainly for the Salesforce administrators out there who are well aware of the Salesforce terminologies and kind of new to Agentforce. So before we dive into learn about Agentforce, I'd like to take a step back and discuss about what's predictive AI and generative AI. And predictive AI is something which Salesforce has been using it for more than a decade now. With predictive AI, basically users can get predictions and recommendations from the historical data that's available in the ARC. And this one requires configurations and rules to be set well in advance. And some of the features are Einstein next best actions, recommendations, and lead scoring. So all these features require the admins to set the instructions or like configurations well in advance, and you'll be able to get the recommendations of it. On the other hand, generative AI uses LLMs are large language models to dynamically create the content. And some of the examples are generating case summaries, account summaries, and also take actions using chat responses, etc. And scope is ongoing. Some of the key characteristics is you need to set, as an admin, you need to set the instructions or guardrails, and also set the relevant actions the agent should take care of. So on the generative AI side of things, there are mainly three pillars, I would say, like first one being the Einstein prompts, and then Agentforce, which was formerly called as Einstein Copilot, and the last one, Einstein model. So for the Einstein prompts, as per the name says, it allows the users to interact with data and using natural language. For example, as an end user, the rep can ask Einstein to give the list of opportunities that has the highest revenue, or give me the accounts from Texas, or so basically it can query the data using natural language and give the outputs to the user. And some other use cases are drafting the sales email, a sales email, summarizing an account with related information like the opportunity and number of cases escalated, which is closed, etc. On the other hand, with Agentforce, which was called as Einstein Copilot, admins can build multiple agents that can take actions across different across different departments. And some use cases are like a sales agent can help an unauthorized user in a public community to get a case detail right from the contact information, using contact information. And these actions used by the agents are basically the flows or apex actions or Einstein prompt templates. And we'll see also a demo quickly in a minute. And the last one, I'll quickly touch base on this one. So with Einstein Model Builder, admins can build their own models or connect the AI with existing models, like from the other platforms like Google, or they can use the out-of-the-box AI models provided by Salesforce. Now let's dive into the demo. So for the demo purpose, I've already created a couple of prompt templates, Einstein prompt templates. So in order to create one, you can search for Einstein prompt builder here. And when you click on new, you'll be able to see numerous options in here. And for the demo, I've created a sales pitch email, which is basically drafting a sales email for the users. So as an admin, I've given the instructions for the Einstein. So what are the information it can consume to draft the email, and what are the other information it can it needs to include in the email. So all these instructions are provided. This is the model that I told earlier. You can bring your own model, or you can use the standard ones. Currently, I'm using the GPT 3.5. Let's see that in action. So let's go to a contact, in this case, Vesh Chopra. And let's say I want to send a sales pitch email to Vesh Chopra as a sales user. So in order to do that, I click on the email icon, and I see, click on Draft with Einstein. And you can select the custom one, which is first sales pitch email. And after selecting the account, it'll take a second, and it will shoot you the email with the merge fields populated. Okay, there you go. It takes probably 5 seconds. And there's your first sales pitch email. And obviously, before you send any email generated by AI, you can review it and make changes accordingly. And you can also revise it, make it larger, shorter, formal, or less formal. And you can send the email. And moving on to the next use case, I've created an account summary with the basic instruction. Summarize the account based on the snapshot account information with some latest news about the account. Do not mention the ID of the account, instead mention the name. So let's go here. And for the demo purpose, I'm using the description field. And when you click on that, Einstein will generate or consume the account data, and it'll give you a brief summary of the account. And then I'll also show you, and this is basically a field summary in prompt templates. In order to configure that, you need to go to the Lightning record page, and then you can select the right field you want to give the summary for. In this case, I'm using the account description field. And I've already configured that in here. And once you select the description field, you'll be able to see what are the relevant prompt templates that you can use in there. And you can see I have the account summary, which I have mentioned the field in here. Okay. And the last one being the demo on the agent. And for the demo purpose, I've created a service agent sphere. And the sole purpose of this agent is to help the customers get their case details just by providing their contact email. So as I mentioned earlier, you can provide instructions to your agent, and those instructions are tied to relevant topics. For this demo, there's only one topic assigned to this agent, like called case management. But if you can add multiple topics to an agent. Under each topic, you provide the instructions, and the topic is about managing a case and helping the customers, providing the case information. And these are the instructions that helps the agent to behave based on the customer's input. And for each of the topics, there could be actions tied to that. In this case, I have a flow which basically gets all the contacts based off the gets all the cases based off the contact's email. So I'm getting the contact using the email provided by the customer, and I'm getting all the cases from based on the contact ID. Now, let's see that in action. Let me refresh it and then start it again. So here you can see that I have a contact open. And let's say, and this is again basic community that I built for the demo purpose. So let's say Wes Chopra would like to know if there's any, like the case information. If I go to the server side, there are three cases for Wes Chopra. Okay, so when I land on the page and click on the chat bar or chat icon, I'm prompted with a message. Hey, I'm Sophia, an AI sales assistant. How can I help you? I would like to get the latest case information. Okay. It'll ask for the email. My email ID is, okay. Let's see if it can provide you the right one. And there you go. So you have all the different cases. I think all the are created on the same date. It shows you the case information. And these are based off of the instructions that you provide to the agent. So in here, as you can see, I've mentioned that, So here I mentioned what are the different information that should be shown to the user, and also I've configured the relevant case accordingly. And these information is shown in the community side. So that's about demo. As the next step, in order to improve your skill set on Agentforce, I recommend you can take these actions. So there's a new status called Agent Blazer that's available in your trailer. So when you land on your trailer page, you'll see something like a banner become an Agent Blazer. And there are three levels in there right now, a champion, innovator, and a legend. And you'll also be given a shiny badge as well. And also you can take the Agentforce specialist certification, and there are trailer modules available. All right, that's pretty much it. If you have any questions, feel free to reach out to me. I'll be happy to answer. Thank you.